This is your health science teacher educational YouTube channel. Today I have my science book with me with many definitions to discuss with you, and it includes many illustrations. Now see the first page of my science book, key terms or clear explanations. So children, we will start learn all about the organisms. Who are organisms? Organisms are living things, and we can group these all organisms as prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Organisms that don't have an organized nucleus are called prokaryotes, and organisms that have an organized nucleus identify as eukaryote. Children, there are many organisms around us, so the classifications of organisms is the easy way to study about these organisms. All organisms on earth, including human, is classified according to two methods, as artificial classifications and natural classifications. Here you are learning about the natural classification. See natural classification of organism. It is explain you the natural relationship among organism in the same species or among the different species. Now let's see about the three domain systems. This is the most appropriate system to classify organism in the natural classification. According to this classification, there are three domains, as domain archaea, domain bacteria and domain eukarya. The organisms belong to domain archaea and domain bacteria are prokaryotes. Organisms in domain archaea have the ability to live in extreme environmental conditions like desert, hot springs, ocean beds, volcanoes. Thermogens and halophils are example for archaea, and these organisms are not sensitive to most antibiotics, so we cannot destroy them with antibiotics. Now our third domain eukarya. There are four kingdoms that belong to this domain. Let's see one by one. Kingdom protista, kingdom fungi, kingdom planti and kingdom animalia. Now turn your second page. You learn about archaea. Now you are learning about bacteria. Bacterium is a singular word. Bacteria, unicellular microorganisms. Some bacteria are pathogenic, that means they cause diseases like tetanus, diarrhea, leprosy, and some bacteria cause cholera. But children, many bacteria are very useful. They break down or decompose dead organisms and recycle nutrients. And bacteria can increase soil nitrate level by fixing atmosphere nitrate. We need them to produce curd and yogurt. Now children, let's define the words microorganism and unicellular. Turn your next page. Microorganisms are very small organisms that cannot be seen with the naked eye. That's why we call them as microscopic organisms. Then unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms. Organisms that are made up of one cell can call unicellular organisms. And organisms made up of many different cells are called multicellular organisms. Plants, animals, some fungi like mushrooms are multicellular organisms. Before moving to eukarya, let's see about viruses. Virus first observed by a Russian scientist Ivanovsky. Viruses are not identified as living organisms because they have both living and non-living features. Viruses are extremely small organisms than bacteria. They can be seen only with an electron microscope. Reproduce is the only living feature of them, but they can reproduce only in the living cells, so they are named as parasite. Host means the cell in which the virus lives. පුතේ ජීවීන් අධ්‍යයනයේදී වර්ගීකරණ classification අපිට අධ්‍යයන පහසුව සඳහා අපි සිදු කරනවා. එතකොට ස්වභාවික වර්ගීකරණය තමයි මෙහිදී ඊටම වැදගත් වෙන්නේ. ස්වභාවික වර්ගීකරණයේදී අපිට එකම විශේෂයේ වගේම ජීවීන් විශේෂ අතර තියෙන පරිණාමික බන්ධුතා ලේසියෙන් අධ්‍යයනය කරන්න පුළුවන්. එතකොට 3 domain system කියන්නේ අධිරාජධානී තුනක් යටතේ ජීවීන් වර්ගීකරණය කිරීම. ආකියා, බැක්ටීරියා, යූකැරියා විදිහට අධිරාජධානී තුනකට වෙන් කරන්න පුළුවන්. ආකියා සහ බැක්ටීරියා ප්‍රොකැරියෝ ආකියා සහ බැක්ටීරියා ප්‍රොකැරියෝට්ස් කියන්නේ සංවිධානයේ වූ න්‍යෂ්ටියක් නොමැති ජීවීන් විදිහටත්. එතකොට ඩොමේන් යූකැරියා වලට අයිති කිංඩම් ප්‍රොටිස්ටා, ෆංගයි, ප්ලාන්ටි ඇන් ඇනමීලියා යන ජීවී යූකැරියෝටික් ඕගනිසම් කියන්නේ සංවිධානයේ වූ න්‍යෂ්ටියක් සහිත ජීවීන් විදිහට හඳුන්වනවා. Now turn to next page. There are 4 kingdoms belong to domain Eukarya. Now let's see about the kingdom Protista. These organisms can be unicellular or multicellular organisms. And these organisms do not feed to plants, animals or fungi. That's why this kingdom referred dustbin kingdom. And here you can pause the video and read more explanation while watching this, okay? See the kingdom fungi. Singular word is fungus. Eukaryotic, unicellular, multicellular organisms. Fungi have plant-like cell but no chloroplast. And these organisms also form symbiotic association with other organisms. Now kingdom Animalia. These are multicellular organisms who are unable to produce their own food. So they are called as heterotrophic. Now see more features of them. They move about and react quickly to changes. And their cells have no cell walls like kingdom Plantae. Kingdom Animalia again can be divided into two groups according to the presence and absence of the vertebral column. Organisms without a vertebral column is known as invertebrates, and organism with a vertebral column is known as vertebrates. Invertebrates can be classified into different phyla according to their features as Cnidaria or Cylindrata, Annelida, Mollusca, Arthropoda and Echinodermata. By considering structural features of the vertebrates, we can classify them into 5 groups as Pisces, Amphibia, Reptilia, Aves and Mammalia. Pisces are the fish that are well adapted to live in water. Amphibians have ability to live in both land and water. Reptiles are cold-blooded animals who have dry skin without glands. And Aves are birds that have adapted for flying. Then what about Mammalia? Animals that nourish their young with milk belong to class Mammalia. Now children, let's clarify these key terms. Species are the group of organisms that can produce offsprings, and their offsprings also can reproduce. Lions and tigers do not naturally interbreed, so they belong to 2 species. Now see the meaning of adaptation. Adaptation is a feature or behavior that helps living things to survive. Camels, long eyelashes and hump are the adaptations. Differences between individuals belonging to the same species are variations. See the examples: eye color, skin color, curly and straight hair. දේපුත්තේ එකිනෙකා අතර අන්තර් අභිජනනයේ සරු ජනිතයන් බිහි කර හැකි ජීවීන් අපි ජීවි විශේෂයක් විදියට හඳුන්වන ඒ වගේම පරිසරය අනුව ජීවීන් දක්වන ඇසිරීමේ හරි ඒ ජීවීන්ගේ තියෙන උපාංගවල වෙනස් වීමකට අපි කියන ඇඩැප්ටේෂන් නැත්නම් අනුවර්තන කියලා. Now the organizational levels in living body, cells, tissues, organs, systems and organisms. Cell is the basic structural and functional unit of the living organisms. Most of cells are microscopic. Then now you know some organisms are unicellular organisms, but most organisms are made up of few cells or large number of cells. So they are called multicellular organisms. Children, when a group of cells organize for a specific function or functions, it is called a tissue. Tissues are the next organizational levels that come after cells. A collection of different tissues work together to perform a specific function or functions is called an organ. A group of organs that work together to carry out a related or specific function or functions, then comes body system. Now children, turn to the next page to learn about the body systems. There are various biological processes in our body like respiration, food digestion, excretion, reproduction. To do those processes, the various organs in our body work together. Let's take an example. The different organs in the digestive system work together to execute the process of digestion. And respiratory system takes oxygen to the bloodstream and remove carbon dioxide from lungs. See gas exchange, breathing and respiration are the different processes, so those words have different meanings. The exchange of gases across the respiratory surface is gas exchange. In human lungs, alveoli have adapted with thin walls to ensure fast diffusion of gases across the surface. The process of taking air into the lungs is known as gas inhalation. Exhaling air from the lungs is known as exhalation. The stored food transforms into energy inside the cells by combining with oxygen is respiration. See the parts of the respiratory system: nostrils, nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, left and right, bronchus, bronchiolus and lungs, two lungs and diaphragm. And the bronchiolus open into small sac-like projection called alveoli. In the alveoli, oxygen diffuses into the blood through the capillaries, and the carbon dioxide in the blood capillaries is released into the alveoli. The nutrition absorbed into the bloodstream during food digestion has to transport to the organs and the cell in the body, and also the carbon dioxide produced in the cells during respiration has to transfer to the lungs, and waste matter also transferred to the liver and the kidney. The circulatory system helps that circulates blood in the entire body. Let's see about the circulatory system. Mainly it consists of arteries, veins and heart. The main organ of the circulatory system is the heart. It has made up of muscles. There are four chambers in the human heart, namely right and left atrium and right and left ventricles. See the blood vessels. The blood vessels that take the blood away from the heart are called arteries. And the blood vessels that bring the blood back from the organs to the heart are called veins. And the arteries and veins are connected to each other through capillaries. The name of the blood vessels: aorta, superior vena cava, interior vena cava, pulmonary arteries, pulmonary veins, tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve. Children, do you know a human has a double circulatory system? Means blood passes through the heart twice in a one complete circuit. Now see, I will explain the cardiac cycle briefly. Blood enters the artery, then the walls of the artery contract. This raises blood pressure. Because of this pressure, because of this force, bicuspid and tricuspid valves are open. Then blood passes through these valves into the ventricles. The ventricle continue to contract and the pressure continues to increase. Because of these, the semilunar valve at the base of the aorta and the pulmonary arteries are open. Then the pulmonary arteries carries blood to the lung. The branches of the aorta carry blood to all other parts of. Children, remember these key points. All arteries carry oxygenated blood except the pulmonary artery, and all veins carry deoxygenated blood except the pulmonary vein, and the umbilical vein and the umbilical artery also like this. Then blood is the transport medium. It is not just a red liquid. It consists different types of blood cells and the blood plasma. Plasma is a liquid part of blood, and red blood cells transport oxygen, and the lymphocyte, phagocyte and platelets are white blood cells. Children, you can pause the video and read these paragraphs. Now let's turn to human excretory system. Removal of the byproducts from the body that are produced during metabolism is known as excretion. Urea, salts, carbon dioxide and water are the main excretory materials of organisms. And the excretory system helps to remove these excretory materials. Human excretory system include the kidneys, lungs, liver and the skin. Now let's see about the urinary system. The main organs are bean-shaped two kidneys. In other parts are renal artery, renal vein, pair of ureters, bladder and the urethra. Here you have more facts and points about digestive system also. You can pause the video and read that. Children, look at the screen. There are two types of digestion, are called mechanical digestion and chemical digestion. Children, do you know when you talk while eating, the food accidentally enters the trachea or your windpipe? It is called chaw. Look at the screen here, the life cycle of a frog and a butterfly. See the common characteristic of living organisms: cellular organization, nutrition, respiration, excretion, movements, reproduction, growth and development. The basic processes of life is called life process. Symbiosis is the close association between organisms of different species. The change of form an organism during its life cycle is called metamorphosis. Look at children, nutrition is the process of obtaining energy to maintain the life. And the production of new generation from their exist generation is reproduction. දුවේ පුතේ ජීවේ මූලික තනුම එකකේ සෛල එතකොට කිසියම් නිශ්චිත කෘත්‍යයක් කිරීමට ඔය කෘත්‍යයන් කිරීමට එකතු වන සෛල රාශියකට අපි කියනවා පටකයක් කියලා. මේ පටක එකතු වෙලා අවයවය ඒ වගේම අවයව කීපයක් එකතු වෙලා අවයව පද්ධතියක් සහ ජීවියා නිර්මාණය වෙනවා. එතකොට අද ඔයා රුධිර සංසරණ පද්ධතිය, ආහාර ජීර්ණ පද්ධතිය, ශ්වසන පද්ධතිය, එතකොට බහිස්රාවය පද්ධතිය යන පද්ධති ඉගෙන ගත්තා. So children, I hope you could learn more definitions about the organisms that can be found in your textbook. So dear, if you like my video, you can like me, comment me and you can share this video with your peers. And thank you children who have subscribed me, and others you can join with my lessons furthermore by subscribing Health Science Teacher YouTube educational channel. So dear children, your next chapter of my science book will be Kingdom Plantae. And dear children, if this pronunciation differ from your usual pronunciation, don't get confused. This is the correct way. I want to make your pronunciation clearly. So use this correct pronunciation. So my dear students, thank you for joining with me to read my science book.